Hey, I'm Alex Radcliffe from Board Game Co., and today I'm reviewing Micro Macro Crime City by Pegasus Bill. And this is an interesting game to review. Micro Macro is a game that I kept on hearing good things about the game, about the genre or whatever it's doing, something innovative it seemed to be bringing to the scene. And Micro Macro is going to be most akin to escape rooms. If you've ever played any escape room games, Micro Macro is going to have that feel. It's not so much mechanics and gameplay in that sense as a insert whatever Euro or who knows what game you're playing. It's very much an escape room. It's very much a looking around, trying to find the clues, the puzzle, trying to find those different things that will give you an experience of playing a game, although really it's just Where's Waldo? And the game is going to involve these cases. You're going to have a bunch of cases over here, just a variety of different options. These are just a handful. There's going to be twice as many in the box. I think there's 20, no, 18, no, something. There's some number of cases. Let's see somewhere here. 16 exciting criminal cases in this game. And we are about, I want to say, 10 or 12 through those cases so far, having tried them. And they do come with stars, little numbered stars on them, showing you which quality or which difficulty level any individual case is. And the game consists of trying to figure out what happened, and then the game walking you back from what happened until you figure out what's going on. So let's just give you an example as I go through the box. I'll go ahead over here. So this is not really a case so much, but if you see over here, you can see this guy over here as he's walking. And Micro Macro has this concept of the passage of time, because if we scroll past the logo, you can see he's down here. And now you can see the same guy holding that little bag, someone's walking towards him, and then a second later, boom, he's dead in the park. That's going to be the concept of Micro Macro. You have this little magnifying glass in case you want, which, while actually not helpful at all for me playing the game, if you're looking at the top camera, it's actually going to make things a drop clearer in terms of your ability to see through it, just because, well, it does magnify things, but it localizes that area into a tiny area. I personally don't find this that helpful. But the idea, oh hey look, here's the spot we're at. It's going to be down here. This is going to be the spot where we were following a second ago. The guy's going to be walking down over here. You see a little criminal. Let's see if we can do it over here. So you see that person over there. He's walking down the block. You see the criminal who's peeking out from behind the convenience store. The man starts walking further over here. The person walks out, and then boom, he's dead in the park. That may or may not be in a case. I think it may have been. I don't recall. But the general idea, the general concept of tracking the passage in time across this Where's Waldo of a case is going to, well, give you the experience of finding things out. You're going to have an individual case that will say things like, oh, we have death from above. We have someone has died east of the market. So that's our first clue. You have to find the market. You have to go east of the market. The market's going to be over here. You can see this whole area of the market. You're going to go east of the market and we find the piano. I'm not going to go further into this case because I don't want to give too many spoilers, but the cards are going to lead you through the journey. You're going to go through the cases one at a time. The cards guiding you through the journey of trying to figure out how the case plays out. That's going to be what this game is giving you. And it's going to ask you leading questions along the way too. In fact, the difficult mode, in case you want to try it, the difficult mode of the game involves not actually being asked those leading questions. The leading questions will be, is there anything suspicious at the scene? You know, where did the person live? What was the motive for the murder? Did they have anyone who wanted to kill him? These are going to be guided questions that help you move through the journey and figure out this Where's Waldo of what's going on across this board. And this board has so much going on in the board. It has a ton of different things. I haven't finalized all the cases just yet, but the amount of stories that are being told in this city as you go through it is astonishing. And I don't know how many of them actually relate to cases or not. That's the core concept of Micro Macro. Figure out some sort of case, where it happened, and then track those clues down towards whatever pathway led you down that route. I like this game with complaints. Micro Macro is a game that the first time I read the rules, it's a single sheet, it's very easy to go through. The first time I read those rules, I was like, this looks cool. It looks like a Where's Waldo. I've heard good things. And then I sat down, I pulled it out, sat down with two friends, and we started looking across the board. At which point I found out that Micro Macro Crime City comes with its own little neck cramp that you get to add to your body as you play. You see, you have this giant map, and as you can see from the camera, you can't see a lot as you play this game. The core concept is phenomenally well done. You do kind of need two players. You could play it yourself. The problem is some of the cards will involve kind of making a guess, and you'll need someone to confirm, yes, you're right or not. So when you have two or more players, one person plays as the clue master, and once you make that guess together, they look, And they're like, oh, no, but then they're kind of out of the picture. They can't continue that journey with you. You have to do it on your own. Of course, playing it solo, you can still power through it and just go ahead and you miss that clue, so to speak. But ideally, this is a game you're going to want to play with two or more players to get that collaborative journey of trying to figure things out. The problem is, the more players you have, the more you're often, not always, often looking at these same spots on the board. Very often, you're trying to figure out a pathway. You see people cramming down around the map, trying to, like, look, oh, wait, nope, the car went here. Oh, wait, no, the car is... And you have the same people doing that same process along the way, looking at the same areas, which means you have this map being constantly pulled and pushed and moved, and everyone's trying to figure out what's going on with tiny pictures. So the concept of the game, the concept of looking around, the concept of trying to find the cases, the concept of trying to go through that process and journey of discovery is amazing. Like, absolutely amazing. This is an escape room game, very much in a typical sense, not in a typical sense, in an atypical sense. It's an escape room game, giving you that escape room feeling as you try to figure what goes on. But it's not about the typical clues of an escape room as you try to figure out what goes together with what, how these cards rotate, align, or any of that. It's literally just about the passage of time. All this game is Where's Waldo? There's not that much more to it. There's a drop of deduction, a drop of choice, a drop of trying to figure out what's going on. It's mostly Where's Waldo, but telling a narrative story that is incredibly impressive at what it's doing. But then along come the neck cramps, and the people cramming over the board trying to figure out what's going on. And then additionally, this is a game that I've particularly been enjoying playing with my kids, and a lot of these cases, I feel this game is so well suited to be a family game where you play with people, and a lot of the cases are very adult in nature. Obviously, people have their own degrees of sensitivities, what they do and don't care about. For myself, I did go ahead and continue playing with my kids, but a few cases I'm like trying to brush past, trying to like, I mean, again, it deals with intense themes like cheating and suicide and all those things, which if you want to do that with your children, that's all by all means. But for myself, I'm a little bit more sensitive to exposing my 5-year-old to themes about suicide. The little case with Batman running around the city, that's excellent. Not actually Batman, because copyright strikes, but it's a ton of fun going on. I just feel like I would love to have the same exact game, just a little bit more sensitivity. Not necessarily a ton, because the truth is, some of these stories, the nice part is some of these stories do give you the feels in a way that the intensity around them, and I don't want to give spoilers, but there's particular cases where you watch journeys of people meeting and things happening and then things happening and then things happening. Excuse my spoiler-free version of trying to tell you what's going on here. Overall, Micro Macro Crime City is incredibly ambitious, incredibly well done, and I love the fact that it's breaking molds. I love the fact that it's doing something new. We don't always see something new. More often than not, we see people iterating upon the same thing again and again and again. I'm not complaining. I usually love those iterations. I usually love the games that we get delivered as they get slowly tweaked and improved to give you the best deck building, worker placement, whatever combination of genres and mechanics you're looking for. Micro Macro is bringing something new the same way escape room games brought us something new when they came out. This is giving us a new version of an escape room, and I am excited to see more from them. I feel like an app might be a great benefit, and I don't love app games, but I feel like this game would do well from having the core map you have here, plus an app. Or maybe even just giving you two maps in the same box. It might remove some of that collaborative nature of you peering over the same area, but it also removes the neck cramp and back pain and three people trying to get their head to the same spot. Having an app where you can scroll across the city, zooming in, and you're like, I'm in D4, I'm in D2, that could really give you the same experience, but with a bit more. You also potentially could avoid having that single player limitation, because a single player could still make a guess, so to speak, and the app could be like, nope, that's not the right answer. Although, depending on the particular question, some of those might be harder or not harder to do. Overall, Micro Macro Crime City is an excellent game, a game that I easily recommend. As far as final thoughts and rating, for me, this is a 4 to 5, but I really went back and forth between that 3 and 4. The game is good. The game is innovative. The combination of just practical accessibility is had me drifting a bit towards a 3. For context, my rating scale is 1s are bad game, 2s are games that are not for me or have too many issues. 3s are very good games, 4s are great games, and 5s are the best games in my collection. Micro Macro is I want to give it a 4. I'm giving it a 4 because it is innovative enough, unique enough, and does have moments of feels in it that really made the experience very rewarding. A At the same time, understand that this is basically Where's Waldo. There's not a lot of mechanics going on here, so this, if that's what you're looking for, this is not going to have a mechanically rich game. It's Where's Waldo. It's great. It's thematic. It's done well. But it's the Where's Waldo of board games. Until next time, I'm Alex Radcliffe from Board Game Co. I hope you enjoyed this video, and as always, have a good one.